What's going on, guys? It's DaVidge. Welcome back to another video. Today we're talking about the 5 dumbest purchases that I have made in my 20s. Let's get straight into the video. Make sure you guys subscribe, hit that like button, turn post notifications on. Remember, do not make these 5 mistakes. Make sure you guys are really paying attention and that you're not making these same mistakes that I made in my early 20s. All right, guys, let's get straight into it. If you are an entrepreneur, you understand that sometimes when it comes to building businesses online, you have to outsource a lot of the work. You can't be doing everything by yourself because guess what? There's not enough time in the day for you to be doing every single task. You have to outsource. So with that being said, you know, there's Fiverr, there's Upwork, those are the 2 more popular apps. But sometimes you just have to use these apps in order to build websites, in order to build your apps or build, you know, certain things that are related to more of the technology side of your business. So there was a time in my early 20s where I was building a website and guess what? I didn't know how much a website should cost. So what I did was I ended up spending almost $8,000, guys, $8,000. I paid a guy from a different country to build this e-commerce website on Shopify. There's themes that you can actually buy on Shopify for between $200 and $300. If I had known that, I definitely would go back and I would have just purchased the theme and probably have built the Shopify store by myself, at least in the beginning stages when I was just testing. But instead, you know, I thought it had to be built from complete scratch and I had a developer build it for $8,000. And for some reason, it took him a month when really it probably should have only taken him a week or two, because all he had to do was download a theme, add the products, add the descriptions, and that was that. So that is definitely the second biggest mistake and it still haunts me to this day. So do not spend $8,000 on a website unless you're building a website for an absolutely massive company that you already are making a ton of money with. I would definitely recommend just trying to do it on your own or find a developer who's a little bit more economical. Something around $500 to $1,000 is probably a better price range to build a website. So that is dumb purchase number 2. Let's get into dumb purchase number 3. Let's go. Let's get into dumb purchase number 3. Now this one really isn't that bad. And look, we all kind of make this mistake, but that is paying a little bit too much in rent than I really should be. So this apartment that I'm actually sitting in right now is an apartment that I got literally less than a month ago. And don't get me wrong, it is fantastic. I get a lot of work done here. And for me, it's really not that dumb of a purchase, but my goal with this number 3 is really to explain to you that if you are in a position of really not having that much income, or you're really struggling financially, or maybe you don't know what you want to do in your work life yet, I wouldn't recommend going out and getting a super expensive apartment paying $3,000, $4,000, $5,000 a month when you can easily just get an apartment for somewhere between $800 and $1,500 a month. I think the key here, guys, is really just making sure that you're staying within your budget and you're not spending money that you don't have. Keep your rent under 30% of your actual income. So that's super important. But again, guys, if you guys are able to do things like house hacking where you're living in the duplex, renting out one of the units and living in the other, or even, you know, if you buy a 2-bedroom, 2-bath condo, you live in one of the bedrooms and you rent out the other, those are always gonna be better options because sometimes if the numbers work out, you can actually end up living for free. So that's obviously a goal. Who doesn't wanna live for free? I would love to. So that's number 3, guys. Let's get straight into number 4. Number 4 is by far the stupidest purchase I've ever made in my life. And that was what is known as gold teeth grills. If you don't know what grills are, they are absolutely ridiculous. By grill, I'm not referring to a grill that you use to cook a sandwich. I'm referring to a grill that you put in your mouth, you know, whether it's diamonds, gold, any sort of jewelry. It's basically jewelry for your mouth. So when I had a little bit of money saved up, I ended up spending a couple $1,000s on a diamond grill. So the mistake that I made besides purchasing it was I actually left it in my car and my car got broken into, hence the grill was then stolen, which actually makes no sense because it's fitted to my teeth and you can't actually fit it in your teeth, but I guess, you know, you can always melt it and take that gold and sell it to a pawn shop or whatever. So that's definitely the stupidest purchase I've made in my 20s. And let's get into number 5. Guys, the 5th dumbest purchase I've ever made is buying followers on Instagram. When I had an e-commerce business a couple years ago, it was a jewelry business, and at the time, I thought that it was so important to have what's called social proof. And because of that, you know, I wasn't able to really grow my Instagram organically, so what I did was take a shortcut and go out and buy followers. So I actually spent over $2,500 on fake Instagram followers, and literally within 3 days, my whole jewelry account was actually blocked, and I wasn't even able to access it anymore because, well, Instagram's algorithm figured out that I had fake followers. Highly not recommend, you know, buying any sort of fake followers because it can negatively impact your business in terms of your social media presence. So definitely not the smartest decision. Those are the 5 dumbest purchases I've made in my 20s. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys have any feedback, you know, make sure you drop it in the comments. And if you've made dumb purchases as well, but you've learned from those lessons, just make sure you guys drop comments down below and, you know, definitely share with us what dumb purchases you've made. and maybe also share some of the best purchases that you made, because I definitely think that's important too. So that's it for this video, guys. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Make sure you guys subscribe, smash that like button, and I'll see you guys in the next video.